What's good, guys? Serie 5 Studio here. I'm Daryl, and this is the first ever GoPro. Now, not a lot of people know that back in 2005, Nick Woodman, the founder of GoPro, started his company by selling film cameras. This is the GoPro Hero, the first ever one. What was special about this was the strap system, which allowed him to take this camera wherever he went, especially when he was surfing or doing other extreme activities. I actually found a clip of him selling this camera more than a decade ago. Here, check it out.
I was always frustrated that I couldn't easily take photographs of my friends and family during our favorite sports and activities.
Right.
And so I figured there must be an easy way to carry and use a camera. So I came up with the Hero camera design, which allows you to securely wear the camera.
Right. Stop coming off.
Totally secure. But then when you want to take a photograph, it just pivots up, take the shot. But then it stays attached, so you don't have to worry about dropping it. And then it locks back down and you can get back to your activity.
Now luckily, I found one in brand new condition. And we're here right now in Hideout in Liwa, Zambales, another surfing community, just 3 hours away from Manila. And I've loaded this one with Superior Extra 400 film. And let's go and test it out. So hope you like that new video, guys. What do you think of the first GoPro ever made? Honestly, I was surprised. I was pretty happy with some of the shots. Considering that this is not really a professional level camera, or it's not really designed to take high definition pictures unlike the modern GoPros of today. Actually, if I'm not mistaken, this is actually the same as with the other unbranded underwater cameras that you can still buy today. I think they're made in China. So to be honest, I think the first ever GoPro was actually more of a novelty item as compared to a professional tool. But I'm still surprised with how good some of the shots looked. It really gave that old school surfer vibe that I really wanted. But if you're looking to do surf photography or any outdoor photography with extreme sports involved, consider getting yourself a professional camera, especially if you're going to use film, I suggest you use this Nikonos 5, which I also used in a previous video. I'll link it down below. And this takes far sharper quality photos. It's well built, it's really heavy, and it's also waterproof, so you can use it for surfing, kayaking, or any other water activities. I think you can also use it in the snow or sand, wherever. But going back to the GoPro, what was actually good about this camera was the strap system. Compared to the modern GoPro accessories, it was actually this one is actually built pretty well. It's really sturdy. Even though I use this a lot in the water, doesn't seem to have a lot of damage in it, considering that this is almost more than 10 years old now. So, yeah, what are your thoughts down below? Are you surprised that the first ever GoPro was even a film camera? Let us know down below in the comments. And if you like this video, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. If you want to buy yourself a GoPro film camera, I think there are still a few left available in eBay. I'm going to link it down below. And if you want more film photography videos, don't forget to subscribe. Now, as for our feature picture for this week, here they are. If you want to be featured in next week's video, just head on over to our Instagram, follow us, and tag us in your photos, and we'll consider it in our next video. Bye, guys.